The mention of a CD release party in Nebraska would probably conjure images of garage bands or new up-and-coming artists from Omaha's famous Saddle Creek Records. However, in this case, hundreds of people from around the state gathered to celebrate the first CD of 84-year-old Betty Naveen from Beatrice, Nebraska, a feat that even her own daughters are surprised by.
It doesn't happen. It just doesn't happen.
For many who know this unassuming, retired school teacher, it came as a surprise that she had quietly been composing big band music from her 100-year-old home in Beatrice.
I was very enchanted with the big bands, and I'd have my ear to the radio. And then, of course, in high school and in college, I went to some of the dances and things, and it was just a thrill.
The music continued to inspire Betty, and as early as high school, she found herself jotting down melodies. This continued through college, marriage, working, and raising three children.
I would come home from school, from teaching, and it was my release.
As Naveen became more serious about her music, she realized something was missing.
There's more to a song than just a melody. You need to have your chords, your accompaniment, and so I found a very fine chord man here in Lincoln. His name was Stanley Capps, Sr. It was through him that I really got very serious about writing my music.
Naveen's partnership with Stanley Capps gave her the confidence to send her music beyond the borders of Nebraska.
I gave my music to a band leader or two, and nothing ever happened. So I guess I was kind of resigned to think, well, this is just the way it's going to be.
But something inside Betty was telling her that her music needed to be heard. She began entering songwriting contests across the country and was getting recognized for her work. After winning a New York songwriting contest, she decided to take it a step further.
I said I'd really like to have someone write lyrics to my melodies.
Through the contest, Naveen met Boston lyricist Les Wallace and decided to enlist his help.
So I thought, well, I'll just send him several of my songs. Maybe I'll get lucky and he'll like one.
It didn't take long for Les Wallace to recognize Naveen's talent.
He did end up writing about three dozen of my songs.
All those wonderful days spent together, those beautiful moments I'll miss. Is there a way to stay lovers instead of us ending like this?
Naveen continued to write over the years, acquiring a trunk full of music so vast that even her family didn't realize the number of songs she had written. Just when it seemed that Betty Naveen couldn't be stopped, she received a blow that stopped her music cold.
In the 80s, probably early 90s, both my chord man and my lyricist died. And so somehow my music went on hold.
In 2004, Naveen suffered another great loss, losing her beloved husband of 54 years, Arnold. It was after Arnold's death that Betty decided she needed to reignite her other love.
After that, I got to thinking, you know, I should do something with my music.
So, with almost seven decades of musical experience, Betty found herself shopping for a new mentor.
Betty came to my doorstep, literally, about 4 years ago. And she had, as I call, a treasure trove of songs. And she said, well, what do we do with the music? And I said, well, what do we do with the music?
I think you're doing fine, Betty.
Music teacher Jim Kadelka recognized the same spark that Stanley Capps and Les Wallace had years earlier seen and signed on to help Betty get her music to the public. As luck would have it, music runs in the family. Betty's cousin, Jerrine Rozick, had already established a career of her own as a big band singer. Despite their similar interests, Rozick was unaware of Betty's trunk full of music.
I did not know. I had no idea that she was writing music. And then she just had this need to to express that to people. And she did to me, and I at first did not realize the full impact of it. And then when I did, it was so heartfelt that she could not be denied. It's like everything just came together at the right time.
Rozek shared the story of her talented cousin back in Nebraska with some musician friends in Denver. And before she knew it, the John Mills Orchestra was jumping on board. Betty was on her way to her first CD.
John Mills was the person who booked me to sing this jazz concert, and he said, how about if we just, Doreen, let me put a band together, and let's get this down on tracks. Let's get this done for Betty. And we all just took him up on it, and it was magic.
Doreen and Jim Kadelka brought in Eric Richards as the fourth member of Betty's dream team.
Eric Richards is a phenomenal arranger, and even the musicians that I work with in Denver are just knocked out by his talent. When the stars all moved into the right position, this did happen.
And on Betty's big night, the turnout said it all. The Lincoln Country Club was filled beyond capacity with friends, family, and all-around music lovers.
She was my college roommate. Wonderful. I didn't know she had all of that talent.
I know that she realizes that she is realizing her dream tonight.
Some might say she was speechless.
Betty is just very unassuming, and she was pleased naturally, but you don't get Betty just too bubbly, too excited. She takes everything in a very quiet manner.
We're just very, very proud of Mom, and people do make dreams come true, and this for Mom is a dream come true.
One look at you set me free.
It was a night that was over 70 years in the making, and one that Betty Nevin won't forget anytime soon.
It's a magical night. It's definitely a magical night.